downtown Los Angeles, bringing you LA Kings Live. Oh, this is a great game. It's the Kings and the Pittsburgh Penguins. Kings have a great record versus the Eastern Conference. Penguins coming in red hot. Sammy.
There he is.
Fagemo. NHL debut. This is fantastic.
He's got the hair going too. Eh? It's flowing. Much like Jeff Carter's hair, exactly. We're going to talk about him later, but...
Yeah, we sure are.
We're 68.
But this is a great moment, man. Yeah. You get to see this a lot.
They let him go out there for a while. I see Jonathan Quick coming out now. He's their starting goaltender for the Kings. But, they let him have about five or six laps there.
Sammy, the winger, is in. Brendan Lemieux is feeling a bit under the weather, not COVID-related. So Samuel Fagemo is making his debut. Two-time champion, Jarrett Stoll and Patrick O'Neill. Stoley, you know, with the way the Kings are playing right now so well, having won 4 or 5, looking to go 5-2 on this homestand, it kind of brings me back to some of the teams that you were on.
Can I back up the truck a little bit here?
Yeah.
I want to congratulate you.
Oh, all right.
With the Angels.
Thanks,
brother. Boy.
Thank you
next
so much.
Next year, secondary announcer.
Thank
right?
you very
play
much.
Play-by-play.
Yeah, that's right.
So you definitely deserve it, bud.
Well, I appreciate that. I was going to throw you some love and say – I learned something from you about this great game every single time I work with you. And I was thinking about to those great Kings teams that you were on. Of course, you won with Jeff Carter, who we'll hear from in the show. It feels like this Kings team right now is playing the best hockey they have in years. I don't know how you feel about that.
Yeah, one of the words that I keep thinking about is balanced, how balanced their attack is right now. And they're not, you know, in years past, it's been kind of the same story with, Andrei Kopitar's line. If they're going, the Kings are going. If their line's not going, they're not going. So now it's just lines 1 through 4. And how many times have we talked about it? There is no fourth line on this team right now. Mm-hmm. There's no third line. There's no second line. There's no first line. It's, you know, everybody's contributing every single night in different ways. You know, you see, like, you know, you got Brendan Lemieux, Arthur Kaliev, Blake Lizotte of late has been unbelievable. Andrei Kopitar had a great start. And then you got the goaltending of Jonathan Quick and Cal Peterson. They've been great. So there's a lot of good things going. The checking, the details of the game right now, how structured they are. They're a very, very tough team to play against. New York Rangers came in, very, very hot team. Mm-hmm. Had a chance to beat the Kings. They would have been first overall in the whole league, and they couldn't do it. So that says a lot about how the team is playing right now.
They've been kind of a streak busters for a lot of teams.
Yeah, a lot of teams.
A lot of really good teams. I go back to that win in Washington. That was fantastic. They played Nashville really, really well, but it was that loss to Vegas – first game of this homestand that, I don't know, turn the tide for this team. They're playing great. And, of course, it's a team game, and we're going to focus on that. But you have to throw out some congratulations to Adrian Kempe.
Yep.
With his 16 goals, which has tied a career high. He's been named an NHL All-Star first time.
Yeah, first time. That's pretty cool. With Adrian, he's got all the tools. You see these highlights here. You're going to see how smooth he is. He's almost toying with you. You know, like he definitely was. He makes it look easy. I don't mean to say that he's, you know, it's so easy for him, but he makes it look that way. And he's got such a good release. His hands, his speed. You see him, you know, race out this play right here off the end boards. And, you know, he's had such a good year. His problem so far has been consistency. Just can he? He gets streaky. He gets hot. I know there was a couple of years ago he had those. Back-to-back hat tricks, I think. He had 6 goals, 2 games, 7 goals in like 4 games, and then he got a little cold. But this year so far, very, very consistent. One of the most consistent players on the team, and that's the reason he's an All-Star.
Yeah, he has been playing fantastic. I kind of think I've been on this bandwagon earlier. I mean, that's right. I'm looking for a little credit on this. I was pumping him up for the All-Star game a long time ago.
You were,
all
right. Patrick. You were.
Making sure everybody's
it's
aware.
It's your day today, so I'm going to be with you, all right?
Well, I hope at the end of the day we're all going to be celebrating. Man, if the Kings can get a W here, that's going to really get I mean, they're in a playoff position for sure. We'll be looking at kind of playoff positioning later on in the show. Let's go to Jim Fox right now. Jim, you're right. We're right next to you, Val. No wonder we feel so good. We're up here with the big boys play. How are you today? I know Trevor Moore is a big topic of conversation. Another player that's really kind of exceeding expectations. I didn't expect this type of level of play from him.
He's just standing out right now, and he's kind of personifying the identity of the entire team for the LA Kings right now, because the one thing that you're seeing from Trevor Moore right now, he's assertive. He's going at you. He's making defenders worry about him. The thing that he's doing as good as anyone right now, he's getting his feet moving before he starts thinking. So he gets the puck, gets moving, then he makes a move. Then he tries to read and react to the play, and that really makes him difficult to stop. We're going to look back at some plays he's made so far this year, and you'll see the constant theme is that feet moving. Get it going. This is the last game against the Rangers. Okay, right down the slot. Doesn't get the shot, but he's attacking. right here. Watch this. Fake. He's right through, guys. Creates a two-on-one right away because his feet are moving. Then you try to make the play, not the other way around. Attack. That's another thing he's doing. He's attacking the net. And whether he's getting the puck to the net for the rebound of Deneau or someone else is going to be involved, this one is going to be Blake Lizotte on the rebound. Gets the puck to the net. So there's a big part of the game right now that the Kings are talking about for themselves, and that is to be assertive, to make sure you're dictating, put the other team on their heels, those types of things. As a team, that's what the Kings are talking about. As an individual player, I don't know if there's a better example of that right now than Trevor Moore, how he's doing all those things that makes the opposition worry about the Kings. Remember last year, the Kings were all about defending, and that was okay. They defended well. They've taken steps. They've improved. Now they're attacking, and now it's working.
Training camp, right, Foxy? One of the words was aggression. And now with that line, with Deneau and with Arvidsson, you mentioned it about a month ago probably on the broadcast about those small area games that they play so well. And with Trevor, that line, they're so good on the cycle. They create in little areas. They can stick handle, you know, they always say in a phone booth or whatever, just kind of in little, small, tight areas. That's hard to make plays in there, and they're doing it, and that's how they're creating chances. Those highlights there were, you know, a lot of them were down the gut there and, you know, in the middle of the ice, taking the puck to the net, but, you know, it didn't show how well they're playing in the corners.
Yeah, just move first, think second, and Trevor's doing that. It's funny, he mentioned the other day, and we kind of laughed about it. He says, when he's on the ice with Arvidsson and Deneau, they're screaming for the puck. They want the puck all the time.
You can hear it up
yeah,
here.
That's right.
You? Yeah.
And he does his job to get it. If I can for a second, guy, two great stories in the world of sports today. Troy Murray, he's back in the booth, the radio booth for the Chicago Blackhawks after a battle with cancer. Oh. So, Troy, great to see you back. And, of course, I'm going to pile on what you said right there, Stoley. Congratulations to Patrick O'Neill. He's moved up with the Angels, way, way up. Congratulations on the play-by-play gig.
Jim, I really appreciate that. You mean the world to me. All of you guys feel like a part of the family. You guys are my family, so thank you so very much.
Great job.
All right, thank you. Jim, we'll catch up with you, of course, during the broadcast, calling the game tonight with Alex Faust, Carlin Bathe as well.
Can I say one word?
Yeah.
Aggressive.
Yeah, you got it out.
There we go.
I was going to try to bring that
up. I messed it up a couple times.
I was going to circle back to that later on.
Okay.
But it's over with
Patrick
now.
Patrick was giving you all this kind of love. Otherwise, they're, foxy. You know?
You're right, though. They have been aggressive. So does Sammy Fagemo, what does he have? Does he have an aggressive style of play? You watch him quite a bit with the interior, right? Yeah. You work at player development. What can we expect from this type of guy?
He is. He's aggressive. He works really hard. He's a battler. He's going to get into the corners. He's going to muck it and grind it. He's got a great shot, too. He's got the skill level. A couple years ago in that World Junior Tournament, which is all the top World Junior, junior players in the world, he led that tournament in scoring, led that tournament in goals. And if I was to say what type of player he is, he's a goal scorer. You know, he's playing with a lot of confidence right now in his last three games with the Ontario Reign, three goals and an assist. So this is the best stretch that Sammy's played this year with the Reign, and maybe no surprise, no shock that he's gotten the call up. So I'm very, very happy to see him in the lineup here. He's excited to get going. I'm sure he's a little nervous, but he's got a great shot, really good release. So if he gets that off tonight, maybe he'll get one.
You know, it was an optional skate this morning, and we're looking at the camera and the monitor behind us. Some line rushes, not sure exactly who Fagemo's going to be skating with. Does he go in right with where Brendan Lemieux is? Would he be on that maybe all Ontario speed line, which we're going to talk about right now? Because Alex Turcotte and Rasmus Kupari, you felt, Jared, we talk about, you know, this team quite a bit, not just on the air, almost all day. You thought that was their best game in a while.
Yeah, and everybody in the facility, practice facility, thought so too. So these guys, you know, they had the puck. Rasmus right there, winning some faceoffs. He was above 50% of the faceoffs, and you see Alex Turcotte right away take the shot. Aggressive, take the shot. Here you go, nice little play. Look at Turcotte in front of the net. That could have been his first career NHL goal, but that's where he needs to be. That's where he was, and here he is here with the wraparound. You know, again, aggressive, taking the puck to the net. Isn't Toby Bjornfoot in all these highlights too? Geez, he had a heck of a game as well.
That's right.
You got Rasmus. He was flying down the wing, just missed the net there. That was really close for him to get a goal, I noticed them almost every time they were on the ice, and Todd McClellan had them out there a lot more. I noticed a couple TV timeouts. The next faceoff was in the offensive zone, and he had their line out there starting that. That tells me a lot right there, and you know, tells me that he's comfortable with Rasmus taking the faceoff, but also usually coaches, you know, put out their top offensive players, you know, after a timeout, well rested in the offensive zone, but that wasn't the case for that line.
Real quick, Kupari's gonna, he's gonna have to play like this. You know that QB Quentin Byfield's gonna get a call up eventually. So it was important for him to have that type of game to show the coaches and maybe himself that that's the way he's gonna have to play.
Yeah, especially this year. He's had a lot of opportunities. He's been in the lineup. He hasn't played one game with the Ontario Reign, so that just tells you right there he's been up the whole time. Yeah, there's guys that have been going up and down with the COVID protocols and stuff like that. This is the year that guys are getting opportunities. Jacob Mavari had his opportunity last week, got in. Sammy Fagemo is having his opportunity tonight. So Rasmus, you know, he has to take advantage. You're right. Threw a good game in there the other night. He's got to keep it going, stay consistent.
Well, again, Adrian Kempe, first-time All-Star. It's been one of those years just full of juice, without question. And we have that interview. Carlin Bathe will speak to the All-Star for the LA Kings representing the Pacific. That's next.